A four-month-old girl presented to the emergency department with low-grade fever and history of daily persistent cough. The infant's parents also reported that stools had become greenish and greasy in recent weeks. Physical examination showed a failure to thrip, and laboratory investigation documented a depletion of the fat-soluble vitamins, particularly vitamin E, that was 3 micromoles per liter. The infant's social interaction and axial tone were good. However, emotricity was characterized by continuous large amplitude axial tremor involving limbs and head. Antigravitary limbs movement were insufficient. She could move her arms toward an object in front of her, but wasn't able to reach it. We conducted a SWIT test and diagnosed the cystic fibrosis, which was subsequently confirmed by genetic analysis. So we started the patient on pancreatic enzyme replacement therapy and polyvitaminic. 1 week later, motricity had dramatically improved. Our patient's spontaneous movements had increased and her tremor had almost disappeared. 1 month later, her vitamin E blood level was in range and neurological examination was normal. Vitamin E deficiency is known to be associated with some movement disorders, including ataxia and tremor. Since the regular monitoring of vitamin levels and supplementation of vitamin E have become standards of care in cystic fibrosis, neurological symptoms have become an extremely rare event, and nowadays they may be mostly seen in infants born in a few remaining countries that are not covered by newborn screening. In Italy, where our patient was born, screening has been mandatory since 1992. The patient did have expanded the newborn screening, but the results were negative for all the screened disease. False negatives are rare, but can occur even in patients with the more severe CRAS3 mutations. Finally, infants with a history of persistent coughing, failure to thrip, and a tremor should raise suspicions of having cystic fibrosis, even if all newborn screening tests are negative.